Pastor, co-workers, and online brothers and sisters, good morning to you.
我感觉到神真的非常的真实。
And I felt that God is so real.
因为呢，在上一章就是第二章呢，就说到有假教师、有假先知的出现嘛。
And because in the previous chapter, it's chapter 2, it mentioned about the appearance of the false teacher and false prophets.
我特别的在今天里面遇到很多的假教师。
And especially today, I met a lot of false teachers.
而这假教师呢，会传染的。本来是一个开始成为假教师，然后就成了很多很多人一起起来做假教师。
And the false teachers will spread because one arises and it will spread to others.
然后就叫我们不用来到这里签到啦。
And ask us not to have to sign up here.
今天开始不用 scan my sajatara 啦。
And from today onwards, you don't have to scan my sajatara.
而且他们的表情是非常的真实的。
And the expression, it sounded so real.
然后最后跟你说今天是4月1号。
Today, they are telling you that it's April Fool's.
愚人节。
It's April Fool's.
Wow, 真的。要小心啊，要防备啊。
So be aware and be alert.
所以今天呢，真的是神透过今天的一个恰巧愚人节，真的是告诉我们，我们会出现有很多很多的假的教师先知在我们的身上。
And through the coincidence of the first April, the April Fool, God is actually telling us there are actually false teachers, false prophets appearing around us.
所以就是像彼得后书这里说的，其实彼得就是在讲着教会面临的这一个的危险。
And just like in 2 Peter, what Peter was mentioning, the danger that the church was facing.
很多的假先知，很多的假教师就在教会里面一直做了很多败坏的事情，还有教导很多怪妙的事。
And many false prophets and false teachers appearing inside the church and they are teaching wicked things.
这个也就是我们这二者常常做的一个很大的破坏。
And this is a destructive work that the enemies always do.
当教会里面有了这一个的危险呢，其实是造成教会一个很大很大的压力。
And when they have this danger inside the church, it actually brings a great oppression to the church.
因为如果教会外面有危险呢，是会使教会更坚固、更坚定的。
Because when there is danger externally, the church actually grows stronger.
但是呢，现在进到彼得后书的时候，彼得真的是在写着另外一个层次的危机，就是教会里面有假教师、有假先知。
But when it comes to 2 Peter, Peter was mentioning another level of danger that is inside the church that have the false teachers and false prophets.
所以今天我要跟大家来分享这一章的主题，就是彼得后书第三章。
And today I want to share with you that is from 2 Peter chapter 3.
在长进中来仰望主的再来。
Looking forward for the coming of the Lord in growth.
是在第十八节这里说的，你们却要在我们主救主耶稣基督的恩典和知识上有长进。
And it, from verse 18, but grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
我把它分为三大段。
And I separated into three sections.
第一到第七节。
From verse 1 to 7.
要被激发，知道末世隐藏的事。
To be stirred up, knowing the hidden things of the last days.
第八到十三节。
From verse 8 to 13.
仰望宽容的主必会再来。
Looking forward for the coming of the long-suffering Lord.
十四到十八节。
And verse 14 to 18.
当殷勤并以得救而长久忍耐。
Be diligent and long-suffering for the salvation.
所以我们先来看第一段。
So let us first look at the first section.
第一到第二节。
From verse 1 to 2.
亲爱的弟兄啊，我现在写给你们的是第二封信，这两封都是提醒你们，激发你们诚实的心，叫你们纪念圣先知预先所说的话和主救主的命令，就是使徒所传给你们的。
Beloved, now that I write to you the second epistle, in both of which I stir up your pure minds by way of reminder, that you may be mindful of the words which were spoken before by the holy prophets and of the commandment of us, the apostles of the Lord and Savior.
相信当时的教会已经读过了彼得前书。
And I believe the church at that time they have read 1 Peter.
而彼得现在再一次的强调说，我在为你们写第二封信。
So now Peter emphasized and said that I'm writing the second epistle to you.
其实目的就是要来提醒、激发当时候的弟兄姐妹的心。
And the purpose is to stir up to remind the hearts of the brothers and sisters.
而这个激发和提醒呢，还在彼得后书一到三章有出现过。在第一章十三节这里也有讲过。
And the stir up and the word reminder also appear in 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 13.
所以我可以感觉到彼得在这写这彼得后书的时候，其实他是带着一个很激昂的心情，很想透过他的书信来激动所有的弟兄姐妹。
And I can feel that when Peter was writing this book, he's with a stirring heart. He really want to stir up the brothers and sisters.
因为彼得知道他的日子已经不久了。
Because Peter knows that he's towards the end of his days.
但是眼前看到的教会还有弟兄姐妹面对的逼迫和危险是其实是非常非常的大的。
But he still see the great dangers and oppression that the church was facing.
所以他要大力的激发他们，让他们苏醒过来。
So he wanted to stir them up so that they can be awakened.
在激发里面也有一个的意思，就是唤醒他们起来哦。
And to stir up, in another words, is actually to wake them up.
唤醒他们诚实的心。
To wake their pure hearts.
就是对主的一个的纯洁的心，当时候信耶稣基督的那个真挚的心。
And the pure hearts, the sincere heart as they believe in Jesus Christ.
而且还要纪念圣先知所说的话，主耶稣所说的话，今天他仍然在我们的当中。
And also be mindful of the words of the holy prophets of the Lord the Savior is still among us till today.
弟兄姐妹，我们的生命的路上成长的路上真的需要不断的被提醒被激发。
And brothers and sisters, as we are growing up, we need to be continuously be stirred up, be reminded.
我们有软弱。
We have weaknesses.
我们有日复一日的忙碌啊。
We have our daily routine of busyness.
甚至我们可能会遇到我们的灵命也会进入一个昏睡的一个的阶段。
Or maybe our spiritual life will go into a deep valley.
因为我们遇到的挑战实在是层出不穷，我们真的很多很多的事情发生。
Because the challenges we face are non-stop and many things happen.
所以今天彼得很透过他的心来激发当时候的教会。
So through the epistles, Peter stirred the church up at that time.
我也相信神今天也要透过今天的晨祷来激发我们对他的心。
And I also believe that through the morning devotion today, God wants to stir our heart towards Him.
所以他说，接下去我们看到第三到第七节。
So continue on, let us look at verse 3 to 7.
他说，第一要紧的，就该知道在末世必有好讥诮的人，随从自己的私意出来讥诮说，主要降临的应许在哪里？
Knowing this first, that scoffers will come in the last days, walking according to their own lusts, and saying, where is the promise of His coming?
因为从列祖睡了以后，万物和起初创造的时候乃是一样啊。
For since the fathers fell asleep, all things continue as they were from the beginning of creation.
他们是故意忘记从太古凭神的命有了天，并从水而出，借水而成的地，故此当时候的世界被水淹没的就消灭了。
For these they willfully forget that by the word of God the heavens were of old and the earth standing out of water and in the water by which the word that been existed perished being flooded with water.
所以呢，我们知道第一要紧的，彼得要提醒我们、激发我们的，其实就是现在真的是有假先知和假教师在我们的当中。
So the first thing to know that Peter wanted to stir up to remind us is that there are false prophets and false teachers among us.
讥诮者就是一个嘲笑者，嘲笑神啊，嘲笑基督徒啊。他说：“哎，你的基督。”怎么说要来？怎么还没有来呀、
啊、？The scoffers are the mockers. They are mocking Jesus, mocking the believers, and asking, "Oh, your Jesus, when is he coming?"
主给你的应许为什么还没有临到啊
？And why is the promises of God for you still not here?
那我看到的，从耶稣出世时到现在，已经是大概有2000年了。 为什么万物和创造起初的仍然是一样啊？
And why since the day of Jesus until now, like 2,000 years, but it's still the same as the creation of the world?
甚至有人说，基督到现在或者是未来是不会来的。
Even people are saying that Jesus won't come again.
他是讲，而且不会成就的。
He just said it only, it won't come to fulfillment.
这就是假教师给我们的谎言。
And these are the lies of the false teachers.
因为他们其实是看不到，故意的忘记。
Because they cannot see, they willfully forget.
他们其实是故意的不去看这一个真实，就隐藏了很多神的话是放在人的身上。
They willfully choose not to see, and they choose to hide the word of God.
所以彼得说，洪水灭世界这件事情。会不见的吗？会没有发生过吗？
So Peter was asking, is the incident of the flood be disappeared?
就是好像在前一章所说的。
And just as was mentioned in the previous chapter.
挪亚方舟的时代，不是神在运行吗？
During the time of the Ark of the Noah, isn't God working among them?
你看不到吗？
Didn't you see it?
所以在第七节，彼得说，但现在的天地还是凭着那命存留，直留到不敬虔之人受审判，造成人的刃子用火焚烧。
So Peter said at verse 7, But the heavens and the earth which are not preserved by the same word are reserved for fire until the day of judgment and perdition of ungodly men.
在创世纪的第一章，我们看到神用话语来创造天地。
Genesis chapter 1, we see that God created the world with His word.
说立就立，说有就有。
He said it with His word.
而今天我们所看见的所有的一切大自然事情，不是存留到现在吗？
And all the things that we see today, all the natural phenomena, isn't it last until today?
我们可以故意说，哦，我们看不到天，没有天啊。
Can we willfully say, oh, we cannot see the heaven, so there's no heaven?
我没有看到人，人已经不见了啊。
I cannot see the people, so all the people disappeared.
但是真实的是在存留着的。
But what the reality is, they are still existing.
保留着的。
They are still being reserved.
为什么呢？
And why is that?
因为神的审判的日子还没到啊。
Because the day of judgment of the Lord yet to come.
因为当神的审判的日子来到的时候，这里有说，必会用火来焚烧。
Because during the day of the judgment of God, here it mentioned that it will burn with fire.
来消灭所有一切不敬虔的，或有所有的事情。
To destroy all the defilements.
所以我们真的要知道，创造毁灭、审判，一切的权柄都在神的手里。
So we need to know that all authority of creation, destroy, and perishment is in the hand of God.
所以我们真的不可以故意悠悠的忘记。
So we cannot willfully forget.
所以当我们有听到很多这样的谎言的时候
，So as we heard all these lies,
我们真的要斥责的，不要让它进到我们的心里面。
We need to rebuke them, not allowing them to enter into our hearts.
所以接下去呢，八到十三节。
So continue on verse 8 to 13.
亲爱的弟兄啊，有一件事你们不可忘记。
But beloved, do not forget this one thing.
就是主看一日如千年，千年如一日，主所应许的尚未成就。有人以为他是单言，其实不是单言，乃是宽容你们，不愿有一人存人，愿乃愿人人都悔改。
That with the Lord, one day is as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years is one day. The Lord is not slack concerning His promise, as some count slackness, but is long-suffering toward us, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance.
彼得再一次的提醒弟兄姐妹，不要忘记一件事情。
And Peter once again reminding the brothers and sisters not to forget this one thing.
就是主看一日如千年，千年如一日。
That with the Lord, one day is as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years is one day.
在诗篇九十章第四节。
In Psalm 94,
在你看来，千年如已过的昨日，又如夜间的一更。
For 1,000 years in your sight are like yesterday when it is past, and like a watch in the night.
就是神看时间是跟人看时间不同的。
And the way God sees time is different from how we see time.
因为神是超越时空，神是在一个永恒的国度里面。
Because God is beyond the time, He is in eternity.
所以当我神在一个永恒的角度来看时间，他可以看千年如一日。
In the perspective of eternity, He can see 1,000 years as one day.
他也可以看一日很长很长很长很长如千年。
As well as he can see, one day is so long that it's like 1,000 years.
这就是我们的神。
And that is our God.
因为他看的时间，他所立的时间，是跟我们有限的看见是很大很大的差距。
Because the way that he sees time that he set is very big different from how we see time.
所以为什么我们常常说，神过去所应许的，所做的事情，今天仍然可以发生。
And that is why we say what God has promised and has done in the past, today it can happen.
未来也可以发生。
And likewise, it will happen in the future.
因为神看从以前到现在到未来如一日。
Because God sees the past, now and future as one day.
因为神就是有一个这么永恒的一个的角度。
Because God has this eternity.
我们不要用我们自己有限的一个的眼光来框住了我们的神。
Let us not limit our God with our limited perspective.
主所应许的尚未成就。
His promise will come to pass.
不是不会成就。
It's not that he's lacking.
是还没有成就。
It's just yet to come to pass.
因为他真的是在单言着。
Because he's delaying it.
单言在宽容着我们。
That he's long suffering toward us.
他的心愿就是不愿有一人存人，乃愿人人都悔改。
And he's not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance.
他都神非常的希望给每一个人有悔改的机会。
And God really wants everyone to have the chance to repent.
在这宽容里面，除了神有耐心的去等候之外，
And in this long suffering, aside from God waiting patiently,
还有一个字我看了之后我也非常的感动。
And there's another word that when I read it, I'm so touched.
就是承受。
That is, he buried it.
原来当神在等我们悔改，等我们回头的时候，是他在承受我们一切的不义啊。
When God is waiting for us to repent, to return to him, he's actually bearing our unrighteousness.
我们做了很多件错事，他都在承受，他在忍耐。
And we have made a lot of mistakes, and he's shouldering and enduring for us.
这个宽容的心是何等的伟大。
And this is such a long, great long suffering.
我在想我自己的承受能力有多大呢？
And I was thinking of my ability to shoulder.
就从我两个儿子开始吧。
And starting from my two sons.
自从我有了孩子。
And since I have children.
我真正的知道我的承受忍耐的程度可以到哪里。
Then I start to know where is my limit of enduring.
我以前我觉得哇，我很有忍耐的。
In the past, I think that, oh, I have so much patience.
我很 kind.
And I'm very kind.
我很 nice.
And I'm very nice.
但我一有孩子了过后，
But since I start to have children,
Oh no.
Oh no.
就是一个小小的事情你都已经承受不到，为什么？
Even such a small matter you can't even think it. It's like why?
房间还是一塌糊涂。
That your bedroom is so messy.
衣服这里哪里？
You just throw your clothes everywhere.
可以抱着衣服一起睡觉的。
And they can just hug their clothes and sleep.
换了的衣服在那边可以三天三夜的。
And the changed clothes they can leave it there for 3 days and 3 nights.
哇，你就真的不能够再忍耐了。
You can't take it anymore.
就开始开战了。
You start the war.
所以真的，我从这里我很感动神给我们的宽容。
And here I really give thanks for the long suffering that God has toward us.
他不是不来呀。
It's not that he is not coming.
他单言，他延迟，他忍耐，他为我们继续的承受，就是要等到我们可以有一个悔改的转头。
He delayed it, he suffered it because he's waiting for us to repent and turn to him.
所以在诗篇86章15节这里说到。
So in Psalm 86 verse 15 it says,
主啊，你是有怜悯有恩典的神，不轻易发怒，并有丰盛的慈爱和诚实。
But you, O Lord, are a God full of compassion and gracious, long-suffering and abundant in mercy and truth.
神的宽容、忍耐都是因为爱。
And God's long-suffering and His endurance is all because of love.
他爱我们。
Because He loves us.
所以他做了很多很多，他不能够容纳，但是他仍然继续的容纳的事情。
And God cannot take it, but He still endures.
虽然神说不愿一人存人。
Although God says that He's not willing that any should perish,
神还是非常尊重人的选择。
But God still respects people's choice.
但是事实上，就是还有很多的人还不能得救。
And in reality, there are still many people yet to receive salvation.
求神来怜悯我们。
May God have mercy upon us.
当我写到这里的时候，我想起我们最近，我们这几年所面对的 COVID 疫情。
And when I wrote until here, it reminded me of the COVID for the past few years.
还有刚刚在这几个月开始的国家与国家之间的征战。
And likewise, the war between nations just happened recently.
可能有很多人说，神你在哪里？
Maybe many people are asking, where are you, God?
神你不是应许会来救我们吗？
God, didn't you promise that you would come and save us?
神你在哪里？
But God, where are you?
其实神在宽容着我们。
But God is actually suffering and enduring for us.
透过这个疫情的一个的觉醒，还有征战的一个的事情，让我们知道，我们真的要回到神的那里。
And through the shaking of the COVID and the war, God is asking us to return to Him.
因为十到十三节这里说。
Because from verse 10 to 13, it says,
主的日子来的时候，像贼来到一样。
Because the day of the Lord is coming just like a thief.
天地都要飞去。
And all things will pass away.
都要被烧尽。
And all will be burned.
所以呢，我们真的不知道神是几时来的。
So we do not know what is the actual time that He will come.
我们非常非常的有限。
And we have very, very restricted.
我们看不到神的时间。
We cannot see the time, God's timing.
神来的时候真的是说来就来，因为一切的主权都在神的那里。
When God wants to come, He will just come because He is reign.
这里说像贼一样，其实不是说耶稣是贼啊。
And here it says like a thief. It doesn't mean that Jesus is a thief.
他是说，如果有人要来偷你的东西，他会告诉你吗？我今天晚上三点要来偷你的鞋子。
He's actually saying if a thief wants to come and rob your house, he won't tell you, oh, 3 a.m. tonight, I will come and steal your house.
明天小心你的车要关门哦。
Tomorrow, be careful, please lock your car.
不会的。
No, they won't tell you.
他就是，他看到他就要来了。
When he sees it, they will just come.
所以我们真的要警醒。
So we need to be aware.
所以在十一节这里说，我们要怎么办呢？
So at verse 11, what should we do then?
我们应该做回我们应该做的事情。
We need to do what we ought to do.
这里说你们为人该当怎样的圣洁，怎样的敬虔，切切的仰望神的日子来到。
It says, what manner of persons ought you to be in holy conduct and godliness, looking for and hastening the coming of the day of God?
所以呢，这里就是该当我们应该要做的，我们先做好。
And ought to hear what we need to do, we need to do it first.
我们不知道的事情，我们交给神。
What we didn't know, we commend it to God.
我们需要圣洁，我们要保持一个圣洁的生命，要保守在这个世上不被玷污。
We need to be holy, then we need to keep a holy life and not to be defiled by the world.
我们需要敬虔，就是以神为我们的中心，常常敬畏神。
We need to have godliness, that is to have God as a center and to revere Him always.
并且带着一个的仰望、期待来等候神再来的日子。
And looking forward to the day of His coming again.
而这里还有一个盼望，就是说，当神来的时候，就会有新天新地。
And here there is a hope, saying that when God comes, there will be new heavens and earth.
有义居在其中。
And righteousness being in dwelling there.
新天新地就是旧约先知所盼望的一个理想的未来的世界。
And new heavens and a new earth is a new world that the old prophets are longing to see.
可能我们会想象，哇，一个很美丽的世界。
And maybe we'll be imagining a very beautiful world.
果树会一直有果子吃。
And I will have fruits to eat.
很多人都是非常的健康，没有疾病。
And everyone is healthy. There's no sicknesses.
但是这里说，必有那个义居在其中哦。
But here it mentioned in which righteousness dwells.
原来新天新地的一个的原则，一个的事情就是。有公义住在其中。
And there's one thing in the heaven, in the new heaven, the new earth that is righteousness.
弟兄姐妹，现今我们所看到的是很多的不公不义的事。
And brothers and sisters, what we see today is a lot of injustice and righteousness.
就是新天新地的还没有来啊。
It means the new heavens and new earth is yet to come.
但是我们应当去行的时候，我们在这地上，我们仍然在这活在这地上，我们行出这个公义。
But what we need all to do is that as we are living on this earth, we need to walk in righteousness.
带出一个公义的社会
to bring out a righteous society.
神就会介入
Then God will intervene.
我们所看盼望的新天新地就开始在启动了
Then the new heavens and new earth that we are hoping for will start to be activated.
求神来帮助我们
May God help us.
真的是一个非常大的奥秘。
And this is such a great mystery.
接下去最后一段就是十四到十八节。
And the last section, verse 14 to verse 18.
亲爱的弟兄啊，你们既盼望这些事，就当殷勤，使自己没有玷污，无可指摘，安然见主。
Therefore, beloved, looking forward to these things, be diligent to be found by Him in peace, without spot and blameless.
并且要以我主长久忍耐为得救的因由，就如我们所亲爱的兄弟保罗。
And consider that the long suffering of our Lord is salvation.
所以为了要防备假教师
and to be aware of the false teachers,
我们真的要殷勤
we need to be diligent,
尽力地保守自己
be diligent to guard oneself.
可以来到神的面前，常常与主有一个很亲密的关系。
That often we come before God and have this intimate relationship with Him.
还有呢，就是我们要长久忍耐。
That we need to have the long suffering.
长久忍耐事情，一些放我们想象的东西，或者是我们期待的事情，是很难的。
And to wait for the things that we really expected for and hope for is very hard.
但是彼得告诉我们，我们长久忍耐是以。主耶稣基督得救的盼望来帮助我们相信神是拯救我们的神。
But Peter is saying that we long suffer it because we have this hope that the Lord is salvation. He is come. He will come to save us.
我们常常想到很困难、很困难的时候，就是要长久忍耐得救的因由，就是思想要转到去主耶稣那里。
So when we face difficulties, we need to consider that the long suffering of our Lord is Jesus, is salvation. We need to consider Jesus.
神已经拯救了我们。
That God has saved us.
我们一定可以靠着主耶稣给我们的恩典。能够越过很多的挑战。
Through the grace that He has given us, we can overcome a lot of challenges.
还有呢，就是我们当在十七节这里说防备。
And here at verse 17, it says that beware.
防备被恶人的错谬所诱惑。
Beware that you fall from that you will be led away with the error of the wicked.
就从自己坚固的地步上堕落了。
That you fall from your own steadfastness.
在十八节这里更是说
And even more at verse 18 it says
你们却要在我们主救主耶稣基督的恩典和知识上有长进
But grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
所以呢，其实在从这整这一段的经文里面呢，神有在防备还有长进呢，有一个很非常重要的语气，就是命令的语气，来告诉我们。
And in these scriptures, the word beware and the word to grow is actually with imperative tone.
怎么样防备呢
？And how can we beware?
就是靠着主给我们仍然有恩典的时候，我们要在知识上不断的长进。
That when we still have the grace of God, that we need to continuously grow in our knowledge.
这知识呢，就是不是说什么。特别的知识就是在神里面的一切的知识。
The knowledge is none other than the knowledge in God.
不断的增长、成长
，continue to grow in it，
让我们的灵命可以 长大成熟
that our spiritual life can grow into maturity.
那我们就有能力来防备很多假教师、假先知的话了
Then we'll have the ability to beware of the false teachers and false prophets.
就好像昨天所说的
And just like what was preached yesterday.
当我们一直摸着真的钞票，我们一摸假的钞票，我们就知道了
When we have a hands on the real notes, then when we touch the fake notes, we'll be alert.
真理只有一个
There's one truth.
但是错谬的教导可以有成百上千个
But there are thousands of wicked teachings.
而且是层出不穷的
And they will just keep coming.
就是我们又要在神的话语里面仍然在神的恩典的日子当中，我们继续的不断的长进。
That in the day of God, that in grace, that we continue to grow in our knowledge.
感谢神
，and give thanks to God.
教会在一个建殿的一个阶段当中
，that our church in the period of church building
建造了建新的建筑物祷告殿。
We are going to build the new church of the prayer, the new house of prayer.
来预备。灵魂的大收割
and to prepare for the harvest of the spirit of the soul.
同样的，我们的生命也要同时的建造起来
and likewise, at the same time, we need to build up our lives.
长进起来
that we can grow.
来帮助更多的人进到神的里面
to help more people to enter into God.
是靠着神的真理
it is by the truth of God.
是靠着神的真实的教导
and it is with the true teaching of God.
这样神来的时候他必非常的开心
Then when God comes He will be so pleased
因为我们已经做了我们该当做的事情
Because we have done what we ought to do
所以今天我们仍然有盼望
So today we still have hope
就是继续长进
That is continue to grow
当我们在长进中我们来盼望主的再来是很有能力的
As we continue to grow, it's powerful that we look forward for the coming of the Lord.
就没有惧怕
Then there is no fear.
没有恐惧
No fear.
看到的就是盼望
And what we see is hope.
感谢神
And give thanks to God.
让我们现在就来敬拜我们的神
And let's come and worship our God.
是的，亲爱的弟兄姐妹们
Yes, dear brothers and sisters.
让我们都一起从我们的座位上站起来
And let us rise up to our feet.
我们坦然无惧地来到神的面前
That boldly we come before God
用我们的心灵和诚实来敬拜他
With our spirit and truth we worship him
让我坦然无惧来到神座前用心灵诚实寻求你我何等地需要你需要更多你的同在在我生命让我坦然无惧来到施恩座前用心灵诚实寻求你我何等地需要你需要更多你的同在在我生命需要你 必呼求，每天都更爱你，永不失去记住爱你的心。
这是我们的祷告，
这是我的祷告，愿我生命单
Father,
让我们每一天都更爱你。
That we can love you more and more daily.
让我们每一天都能够更多的来亲近你。
That daily we can come and draw close to you.
求主你来帮助我们。
May God you come and help us.
求圣灵来引导我们。
May the Holy Spirit come and lead us.
谢谢你。
We thank you.
奉主的名祷告。
In Jesus' name we ask.
Amen.
Amen.
今天这一章。
And today's chapter.
真的是在提醒我们
It's really reminding us
我们要到底要站哪一边呢
And which side do we want to take on
这里有三种人
And here there are three groups of people
第一种是讥笑的人
And the first type, the scoffers
第二种呢就是假教师
And the second type, the false teachers
强解经文的人
And those who twisted to digest the Bible
还有一种
And the third group
就是盼望主再来的人
are the one who hope for the coming of the Lord.
我们来想想看
and let us recall this.
可我们在这一个的环境里面
that we are in this environment.
在这世代的里面
that in this generation.
我们很容易被迷惑
we are very easily being deceived.
我们很容易被引诱
that we are being tempted.
可能我们被这些讥笑的人还有假教师就已经是迷失了原本神要我们站的那一边
Maybe we have lost the side that God wanted us to stand because of the scoffers and the false teachers
我们到底要站哪里呢
So which side do we want to take on?
求主来光照我们
May the Lord reveal to us
来审查我们的心
To review our hearts
我们到底有被迷惑了在哪一方面已经迷失了已经失去在这一个的正道上呢
that
没有站住站立得稳呢
that Is there in any area that we have lost our standing truth
求神来帮助我们
May God come and help us
现在是有一段时间我们跟神来面对面的时刻
There is a time, this period of time, let us come and face God face to face.
我们要选择站在哪一边呢
And which side do we want to choose?
求主
兄姐妹，今天我们就要做一个的选择。
Today we need to make the decision.
左边就是那一个跟随讥笑的人，然后还有假教师的。
And left hand side, you are following the scoffers and the false teachers.
右手就是在要跟随盼望主再来的。
And the right hand side, you follow those who are hoping for the second coming of God.
盼望主再来的人是怎么样的呢？
And what kind of a person is the one who expect for the coming of the Lord?
是当圣洁、当敬虔、当殷勤，还有当防备这一些所有敌对神的人。
And one who is holy, who is godly, who is beware and alert of and all these wicked people.
这些讥笑的人，还有假教师。就是抵挡神话语的。
And the scoffers and the false teachers are against the teaching of God.
无论是在现场或者是在网上的弟兄姐妹，我们要站起来。
And no matter on site or online, the brothers and sisters, let us all rise to our feet.
现在我们就要看，我们要选择站哪一边。
Let us see which side do you want to take on.
是左边呢，还是右边呢？
Is it left or right?
我们来。做一个的选择。
Let us make the choice.
一、
One,
二、
two,
三、
three.
是的，主耶稣。
And yes, Lord Jesus.
今天是我们一个的 prophetic act.
And today is a prophetic act.
就是我们要选择站在跟随主，还有盼望主再来的人。
And today we want to choose to stand with those who expect and looking forward for the coming of the Lord.
弟兄姐妹，我们一起来宣告。
And brothers and sisters, let's declare this together.
主耶稣
，Lord Jesus，
今天
，Today，
我们要定义的选择。
We are determined to choose.
跟主你站同一边。
To stand together with you.
我们要盼望主你再来的日子。
We want to look forward for the days of your coming.
我们盼望神你的应许。
We expect for your promises.
都要一一的成就。
They will come to pass one by one.
我们选择。
And we choose.
我们当圣。
That we want to be holy.
当敬虔。
That we be godly.
我们当殷勤。
Be diligent.
我们也要当这个防备。
And beware.
我们要在神你的真理里面长进。
That we can grow in your truth.
我们要坚持。
We want to persist.
我们不要被迷惑。
And not being deceived.
求主你的圣灵来帮助我们。
That Lord, your Holy Spirit, come and help us.
让我们不失脚。
That we do not fall.
让我们站立得住。
We can stand fast.
站立得稳。
We can stand firm.
直到我们见主你的面。
Till the days that we see you face to face.
求圣灵来大大的来高牧我们。
The Holy Spirit come and anoint us greatly.
充满我们。
Fill us.
奉主耶稣基督名字。斥责。
To rebuke.
所有曾经迷惑我们的话语。
The words that deceived us.
让我们失去所有信心的。
That cause us to lose faith.
都要完全的连根拔起。
To uproot them.
That
we can have the faith of God in us.
使我们能够坦然无惧地来见主你的面。
That boldly we can come before you, God.
谢谢你，耶稣。
We thank you, Lord Jesus.
奉主耶稣基督的名字。
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. In this book, Peter,
他三次说亲爱的弟兄啊
For three times he said beloved
四次啊
Four times
所以第八节他说但是亲爱的弟兄啊
Verse 8 but beloved
然后所以亲爱的弟兄啊是四节
Verse 14 therefore beloved
所以他用一种、就是苦口婆心啊我们说
And he's speaking with his whole heart
因为他已经、在一个非常不容易的世代
Because it's in a generation that is not easy
他也看到日子将近了
And he also see that the days are coming.
但是神的日子还要继续的哦。
But God's day will continue on.
所以特别第八节他说不可忘记啊。
Especially verse 8 says, do not forget.
主看一日如千年，千年如一日。
That the Lord sees one day as 1,000 years, 1,000 years as one day.
所以这一个不要忘记是一个命令的语气啊。
And do not forget is with imperative tone.
换句话说，我们要用主的眼光来看现在。
It means with God's perspective, we need to see it now.
虽然很多的情况告诉我们，耶稣再来日子很靠近。
And although a lot of situations telling us that the day that Jesus is coming is very near.
所以很多人就在追这一方面的信息。
So many people are pursuing messages in this direction.
可能就会忘记到底我在现在应该做什么。
But they will forget what they ought to do right now.
所以他说你一定要不可以忘记主看的日子和你看日子是不一样的。
So he says do not forget that the way that God sees a day is different from how we see it.
因此在第十四节他说所以亲爱的弟兄啊。
So he says in verse 14, therefore beloved.
我盼望这些事呢你当殷勤。
Looking forward to these things, be diligent.
意思说也是一个命令语气。你就要竭尽所为，赶紧，急忙的。
And it's also with imperative tone that with all the effort and make haste.
所以很多人在知道主要再来呢，我们在研究这些课题，我们什么都不做。
And there are people who know that God is coming and they are studying this topic and they do nothing else.
我们知道主要再来，我们更要殷勤做主工啊。
But when we know that God is coming, we need to be even more diligent and do the work of God.
所以彼得在他最晚年的时候是上刀山下油。油锅的一个状况。
So Peter during the later years of his life, that is at the age of all these dangers.
因为你在初期教会，你研究他们真的是为主啊，不怕死的。
Because if you study at early churches, they dare to die for God.
非常的殷勤的来服侍神。
They are diligent in serving God.
并且一直保护自己，不要有污点，不要得罪神，不要离开神。
And they also guard themselves to be blameless, that they can not leave God.
所以彼得是这样来劝勉我们的。
And this is how Peter exhorted us.
所以你他说你要殷勤。
So he says be diligent.
并且要长久忍耐为得救的因由，意思说被引导啊，被圣灵引导，因着神的这个救恩被引导。
And consider that the long suffering of our Lord is salvation means is to be guided by this salvation.
而且要在神的话里面站稳了。
And we need to stand fast in God's word.
意思说站在这个救恩里面呢，我们要得着我们那一个永生的盼望。
Means that we are standing in this salvation, we need to have this hope of eternal life.
不要自取沉沦了。
And let us not fall away.
不要自己在追一些自己想要的东西。
Or pursue after our own lust.
而真的是知道主的心是什么。
But to truly know what is God's will.
所以在十七节他就说亲爱的弟兄啊，你们预先知道这个事，我先提醒你了。
So verse 17 says, you therefore beloved, since you know this beforehand, I just remind you.
所以当防备了。
So beware.
所以今天我们就是殷勤工作，防备这个假教师。
So today we need to be diligent at work and we beware of the false teachers.
然后十八节他说你还要在主耶稣基督的恩典和知识上有长进，这些都是命令语气。
And verse 18, but grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, all these are with imperative tone.
所以我们知道耶稣来的日子近了。
And we know the days of Jesus coming is near.
所以不要追一些让你天上飞到不能下来的东西。
And let us not pursue after things that we just fly in the sky.
那是殷勤的服侍神啊。
But diligent in serving God.
用你能够再生的日子，不要有玷污，一直走到你人生的最后啊。
With the day of your life, be blameless and just walk towards the end of your life.
而且呢，长久忍耐来跟随神啊。
And with long suffering, we follow God.
并且防备这一些假教师，不要让你的眼睛呢被迷糊了。
And beware of all these false teachers, not being deceived by them.
因为这一些会迷惑你，使你走错误的一个地步的。
Not let them be blurred your eyes that you will take the wrong path.
反而要在神的恩典里面，还有在知识上有长进啊。
But instead, be in the grace and grow in your knowledge.
哇，彼得在他最后的一章里面。
So in the last chapter of Peter,
他真的是用一个长者的心来跟我们说话。
And he spoke to us as an elderly.
他要我们怎样在现在做应该做的事。
He wanted us to do what we ought to do at this time.
所以这里有几个很重要的动词，而且是命令的动词。
And here there are a few very important active verbs with imperative tone.
亲爱的弟兄姐妹
，So brothers and sisters，
无论你在牧养上真的很用心在牧养
，No matter that you are being diligent in shepherding，
在追求主的事上很认真的在追求
，You're being diligent in pursuing God's matter，
为主做见证也很努力的做见证
，And being diligent to testify for God，
不要因为别人使你的信心软弱
，Do not let your faith to be weakened by others，
人可能会拒绝你
，Maybe people will reject you，
人可能会批评你
，They might just blaspheme you，
人可能会。讲一些很讽刺的话
They may just criticize you
但是记得
But remember
我们在这一条路上是很久忍耐的
In this journey we need to be long suffering
因为最终我们要见主的面啊
Because in the end we will see God
我们要在看到神的恩典啊
We want to see His grace
所以我们是在神的我们说安然见主所以有一句话 In peace 我们找到主
That in peace we met God
我们要安然见主
That in peace we'll see him
因为我们完成我们该完成的
Because we have accomplished what we have done
所以我们有很多东西要完成
And there are many things we are yet to accomplish
目不转移完成神托付你的
But be focused and do what God has entrusted to you
我要完成的东西就是我要建立教会
What I need to accomplish is to build up the church
我要预备我的下一代将来一个安寝的地方
I need to prepare for my next generation to have a peaceful place
我要继续的殷勤服侍
I need to be diligent in serving him.
我要为我的下一代预备人啊。
And I need to prepare for the next generation.
我要为我的下一代预备场所啊。
And to prepare the venue for them.
我要为我的下一代预备基础啊。
And to prepare the foundation for the next generation.
所以不断的教育。
So continue to teach.
不断的栽培。
Continue to nurture.
不断的用生命树建造他们。
And continue to build them up with the tree of life.
这一些都是殷勤去做的。
And all this we need to do with diligence.
因为我们知道这个日子一定会来。
Because we know that the days will come.
但是我们不能转移目标。
But let us not lose our focus.
所以求神恩待我们。
So may God have grace
for us. 所以我们来到你的面前。
Lord, we come before you.
为全体的弟兄姐妹交在你的手中。
And we commit all the brothers and sisters into your hands.
当他们在殷勤跟随你的时候。
As they are being diligent and following you.
主，这是你喜悦的。
Lord, this is what pleasing to you.
他们也有智慧能辨别。
That they have the wisdom to discern.
主，从你那里得着智慧哦。
And to receive the wisdom from you, God.
而且他们也懂得怎么样来保护自己。
And they also know how to guard themselves.
并且他们继续的长。
That they continue to grow,
继续的明白
and continue to understand.
因为神你的启示继续透过你的话语要分解更清楚
Because your revelation through your words will explain to us even more.
我奉耶稣基督的名
In Jesus' name,
恩待我们全体 GA 六一零两堂的弟兄姐妹
Have grace upon our brothers and sisters of GA 61.
还有很多跟着我们晨祷不同地方的弟兄姐妹
Likewise, so many of the brothers and sisters following our morning devotion from different places. May your love be with them.
让他们真的安然见你的面
That in peace they can meet you
也保护他们手中所做的工
And keep the work of their hand
让他们全心全意得着他们应该得着的
That wholeheartedly they can receive what they ought to receive
祝福他们
Bless them
祝福他们手中所做的
Bless the work of their hand
谢谢你
We thank you
祷告奉耶稣的名
And we pray in Jesus' name
Amen
Amen
上帝祝福你们
May the Lord bless you
我们今天晨祷到这里
And today, this is the end of our morning devotion